Hello students, in this video I am going to explain the separation of mixture of primary, secondary and tertiary amines. There are many methods available for the separation of these amine mixtures, but in this video I am going to explain one of the separating method, that is the Hofmann method. In previous video you can see that I already explained the separation by using Hinzberg method. Okay, before explaining that, let us see what are amines and what is the difference between the primary, secondary and tertiary amines, where amines are the derivatives of ammonia, which is having the formula NH3, in which one or more hydrogen atoms have been replaced by alkyl group. If one alkyl group is replaced, then it is considered as primary amine. If two alkyl groups are replaced, then it is considered as secondary amine. If three hydrogens are replaced by three alkyl group, then it is considered as tertiary amine. Okay, if three are mixed, then we can separate by using many methods. In this, I am going to explain Hofmann method, where in Hofmann method, we are going to use the Hofmann reagent, that is the diethyl oxalate, that is commonly also called as Hofmann reagent. When we treat this three amine, mixture of amine with diethyl oxalate, it reacts with primary amine, secondary amine, tertiary amine, different way. How it is going to react? Let us see that. That is the primary amine, having the formula RNH2, and the diethyl oxalate having the formula CO2C2H5O. When primary amine, two molecules of the primary amine, which is going to react with one molecule of diethyl oxalate, and we'll get the substitute oxamide as a product. And the ethanol as a byproduct. So, arrow mark, you can see that how the removal of the ethanol takes place, that is shown in the slide. So, to removal of ethanol takes place, whatever the form product, substituted oxamide, that will be in the form of solid. Okay, whatever the primary product which is reacted, that will be in the form of solid. How secondary amine is going to react with Hofmann reagent, let us see. Secondary amine, which reacts with only one molecule of amine, which is having a formula, general formula, that is R2NH. Since there is only one hydrogen, it reacts with only one ester group. As a result, we are going to get dialkyl oxamic ester. Okay, whatever the product, that is dialkyl oxamic ester, which is having the general formula, that is CONR2 and CO2C2H5, where we consider R2 for any alkyl group. Okay, that will be in the form of liquid. Whatever the primary product, that will be in the form of solid, and the secondary product, that will be in the form of liquid. Now let us see how the tertiary amine is going to react. Since formula of the tertiary amine, that is R3N, once again there is no available hydrogen for the reaction. As a result, tertiary amine does not reacting with Hofmann reagent. It remains as a solid. Okay, among these three, primary amine product and the tertiary amine product and the secondary amine product, when we subjected to the distillation, among three, tertiary amine being a more volatile, which collected as a distillate at the beginning. Okay, since it is a highly volatile compared to other two, which get collected in the conical flats at the beginning. You can see this side. This is the distillation instrument. So when we add these three, primary amine product, secondary amine, and tertiary amine product, tertiary amine being a more volatile, so which vapors passes to here, which get condensed and collected in the conical flask as a distillate. So we got the pure tertiary amine. Now let us see what about the secondary amine product and the tertiary amine product. So since secondary amine product is liquid as well as primary amine product is solid, by the direct filtration we can collect it in separate beaker. After separating that, we have to treat those substituted oxamide as well as oxamic ester with the alkali to get the original amine. Go through the slides, you can see that is CONHR, that is the substituted oxamide, that is the product of the primary amine. When it is treated with any alkali, here example which is taken is KOH, which gives the pure primary amine. Similarly, that is the dialkyl oxamic ester, which is collected in the separate beaker, that is in the form of liquid. When it is treated with sodium hydroxide, we will get the R2NH, that is the pure secondary amine. So in this way, one can separate the mixture of primary, secondary and tertiary amine. Let me once again explain briefly. In Hofmann method, we are treating the mixture of primary, secondary and tertiary amine with the Hofmann reagent, that is nothing but the diethyl oxalate, which reacts with primary amine, which gives the substituted oxamide, that is in the form of solid, and also which reacts with the secondary amine, which gives the diethyl oxamic ester, which is in the form of liquid, and it does not react with the tertiary amine since there is no available free hydrogen. So when after reaction, when we subject it to the distillation process, tertiary amine being a more volatile, which get collected as a distillate at the beginning, so we got the pure tertiary amine, and among two, whatever the left in the R, whatever the reactant left in the RB, that is the product of the primary amine and the secondary amine, among two, one is solid, one is liquid. When we filter, we can separate easily. So those two separately treated with, when we treated with alkali, we will get the pure primary and secondary amines. Thank you.